It is still a long road to justice for the family of Stephanie Morah, a 9-year-old girl who was shot and killed by a police officer while at the balcony of her home in Mathare North way back in August 2017. An inquest into her death revealed that she was deliberately shot by a police officer. However, the identity of the officer who pulled the trigger is still a mystery in what the court terms as the blue code of silence. As Raquel Muigai reports, the family has since moved to Kisii County, a decision the father believes will keep his family safe.
It is not as easy to identify Stephanie Morah's grave here at Mangai Secha village in Kisii, where she was laid to rest after her death on 12th August 2017.
Mtoto alikuwa mdogo, aliuliwa hakuwa anajua kitu. Mtoto hakupiga kura, lakini wamemuua.
Just like her grave, so are the circumstances surrounding the identity of the police officer the court links to her death. Morah was shot while playing at this balcony when chaos erupted in Mathare North Area 2 soon after the announcement of the general election's results. According to an inquest into her death, the court ruled that the death of the deceased was by deliberate shooting by a police officer whose identity has been frustrated by police officers covering for one another under the blue code of silence. The ruling further cites that based on the independent policing oversight authority officer investigating the incident, there was lack of cooperation from the police in making available the requested police documents that could help ascertain the formations of the officers deployed in the area, the stations they were drawn from, and the specific officer responsible for the shooting.
Kuliko nipate haki, mimi naendelea kurusi. Ile pesa yote nilikuwa nayo nimeitumia kwa barabara. Mara wale witness wangu walikuwa wanataka niwalipie fare ili waende kotini.
11 witnesses testified in the inquest. Based on their accounts, the ruling stated that the police officer who was in the company of another and clearly visible to the witnesses took aim of the point where the witnesses were, pointing his gun at them. In the first instance, the officer crouched down, took aim and pointed, but dropped the gun. He did so a second time and fired. He was identifiable from his appearance of being of light complexion. The two police officers were in jungle green uniform. Moreover, the court cites that the spent cartridge, which was issued for ballistic examination 2 months after the incident, was in fact not the one used to shoot the deceased.
Wameua mtoto wetu, hawataki kusema.
Kwa hivyo, huyo asigali mwenye alimtoa uhai. Nitaweza sema, Mungu aendelee kumsaidia tu.
Unfortunately, Morah's incident is not isolated during the general elections period. Samantha Pendo, a 6-month-old baby, died after sustaining injuries on her head caused by police officers dressed in jungle green uniform in Kisumu. Privala Chiang, a 17-year-old boy, and Raphael Ayeko Chiang, who were both shot at close range by police officers in jungle green uniform and anti-riot gear with their hands raised in Babadogo, Nairobi.
The ruling delivered here on the 15th of March 2021 following an inquest into the death of Stephanie Morah has now been forwarded to the Director of Public Prosecutions for necessary action. But whether or not the blue code of silence will be broken to identify the police officer who pulled the trigger still remains a mystery. For the family of Morah, however, every passing year diminishes the hope of them ever finding justice. Raquel Muigai, Citizen TV, Nairobi.